Hi, I'm Wendell Lake, a physician and neurosurgeon at UW Health in Madison, Wisconsin. One of my areas of special training involves helping those with tremor-related conditions such as Parkinson's disease, essential tremor, or dystonia. This may involve treatment called deep brain stimulation, also known as DBS. By viewing these videos, you will learn more about the process, why it's done, and who it may benefit. You will also learn about what a DBS patient can expect before, during, and after the procedure. Deep brain stimulation is a treatment where electrodes are implanted in specific areas of the brain, and electrical impulses are used to reduce tremor, rigidity, and other unwanted movements due to brain disorders or diseases. The small battery used to power the system is placed just below the collarbone in a fashion similar to a pacemaker for the heart. DBS is not a cure and does not halt progression of the disease, but improving these symptoms can greatly improve the quality of life for those suffering from these illnesses. There are two types of DBS surgery, asleep and awake. These are explained elsewhere on this website. Your neurosurgeon will explain why one type is recommended for your specific case. While each patient must be evaluated individually, in general, the best candidates for DBS are healthy enough for surgery, have time over the next few months to attend appointments for adjustment of the DBS system, have had medication trials through their neurologist, and have a support system of family and friends. During the time patients are considering DBS surgery, we invite them to review these videos, read the appropriate Health Facts for You documents, and talk to patients who have had the surgery. This can be arranged through our office. We want to make sure that all questions are answered by the neurologist and neurosurgeon before you proceed to surgery. Brain surgery does have some inherent risks, such as bleeding and stroke, but the incidence is less than 1%. Other less serious complications, such as infection or equipment malfunction, are also possible, but the risk of these is below 5%. These minor problems can be addressed with removal and replacement of all or part of the DBS system. Once the DBS surgery is completed successfully, the benefits should remain, assuming that programming with neurology and appropriate adjustments are made through the life of the system. It is also possible for DBS patients to have MRIs in the future, but it is important that the patient inform their physicians about their DBS surgeries so adjustments to the MRI can be made if needed. Please see our other videos that talk about other parts of the DBS process. Printed information called Health Facts for You are also available either online at uwhealth.org or from our clinic.